I am Sedat from Castro University. Today, I would like to present a part of my doctoral studies here. I would like to explain my presentation topic is the polarity-based flexible piezo-resistive pressure sensor. I would like to explain my presentation under four headings. Polarity is our main material, centers of the polarity, fabricated pressure sensor, expansion resource. Polarity development started in 1947. Three types of polarity were developed, and we choose the, these are the polarity, polarity N, polarity F. Some element, for example, chlor is attached to its main structure and is called a polarity. We selected polarity. Polarity is used in the industry, especially such as the aerospaces, automotive, MEMS applications. It provides a protection of the devices, components, and surfaces by coating them. It is coated on the surface at room temperature. It is chemically and biologically inert material, and it makes an excellent barrier material. It has excellent electrical properties, such as a low dielectric constant, low loss with high frequency, high dielectric strength, high bulk and surface resistance. It has a good thermal endurances. And has a mechanical properties. It is stable over a very wide temperature range from minus 200 Celsius to plus 200 Celsius. Polarity coating exhibits very low permeability to moisture and gases. Polarity is used as a coating material, but it is piezoelectric properties was discovered for the first time in 2011. Although it's a very low piezo properties compared to the most well-known PVDF material, I think it will be improved over time. I have fabricated flexible pressure sensor for the first time by using its piezoelectric properties. I would like to explain how I fabricate polarity. Before starting, I want to give a little information about the monomer, dimer, and polymer. Monomer is a non-repeating structure at the smallest units. Dimer is a two monomer attached to each other. A polymer is a many monomers attached to each other. Polarity is synthesized CVD method. CVD method consists of the four section. One is sublimation, pyrolysis, deposition, and cold trap section. The chemical company sells polarity as a dimer, granular dimer form, and granular dimer form put into this chamber, and the dimer is vaporized from the solid direct into the dimeric gas at 150 Celsius. Later, the dimeric gas is transferred into the pyrolysis furnaces. Pyrolysis furnaces, temperature of the pyrolysis furnaces is 650 Celsius. When dimeric gas goes through this into these furnaces, dimeric gas is heated and split into the monomeric gases. Monomeric gases is going into deposition chamber, coating chamber, with using argon gas and vacuum pump. With decrease in temperature, this monomeric gas combined to form polymeric structure and coated on the substrate. If pearlen escape from the coating chamber, cold trap captures the excess of the pearlen at the end of the process stage. The process of fabricated pressure sensor is seen here. Six steps is here. These are the pearlen film fabricated by the CVD method. This is rectangle shape and square shape. Pearlen C film and 1,2-chlorobenzene are placed into the beaker, and magnetic sinterer is slowly heated and sintered at 160 Celsius for 3 hours. Later, polyurethane is added at 160 Celsius for 1 hour. After that, this material mixture later this baker is poured into the petri dish and waiting at 50 Celsius for 60 hours to dry into the oven. Later this mixture is cut into the suicidal pieces. Later you see that this polymer structure, polymer material. Copper is used for a top and bottom electrode, and polyamide tape is used for encapsulated encapsulation layer. This is our experimental experimental room, experimental devices. This is a universal testing system. It uses for applying pressure. This is Keitley 6517B electrometer. Uses for measuring the resistance, because this polymer's resistance is very high. It is higher than the 10 gigaohm. Gigaohm, very, very high. These are our experimental results. You see here this pressure and get and got the result, get data according to the ratio of the resistance of the initial resistance versus time. This is the one repetition, one reps. When pressure is applied, the ratio is nearly zero. This is the parasite, and pressure is loaded. This sensor, the ratio is increased. The average response time is 0.37 milliseconds, and the average relaxation time is 0.37 meters, and it's same. Okay. This is the calibration graph. When pressure increases, the ratio increases, and after this point, the ratio is stable. These values give the information about the detected pressure range. The higher sensitivity values, the better pressure sensing. Summary and next step. It provides protection of devices, components, and surfaces by coating them. Its basic property was discussed for the first time. It can be used in sensor application to detect low pressure range below the 10 kilopascal. By coating polymer material between two electrodes, we can make flexible pressure sensors and tactile sensors. Tactile sensors is a type of the pressure sensor that pressure sensor is located by a matrix form like this. Sorry. These are our prototype material. This is a 1x1 matrix form pressure sensor. These are the tactile sensor. This is the sensing area. This is the dimension of the size 50x50 millimeter square. These are the 10x10 tactile sensor, and this the dimension of the 1x1 10x10 is approximately 30 by 30 millimeter square. Our aim is to detect the low pressure and create a pressure mapping of the surfaces. These are the three dimension and two dimension graphs. Thanks, this study is funded by TÜBİTAK. And thanks for attention.
Thank you.
Thank you for attention.